future, talk radio will actually educate, inspire, and make you think. The future is now. Topics and music that affect your life from Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at ubnradio.com. Love, it's not always an easy thing, but when you find it, there's nothing like it. And Finding Cupid with David Cruz is here to help you do just that. It's a show where celebrity guests, singers, writers, and friends all come together to talk about one thing. Love. Finding Cupid with David Cruz. Only on UBNRadio.com.
Good morning and welcome to Finding Cupid Radio. My name is David Cruz. I'm your host for this show, coming to you live from Sunset Gower Studios here at the Universal Broadcasting Network. Thank you so much for joining us. Great show coming to you today. So happy to be back. The entire cast is here. Natalie has been gone for a while. We took a little break for Easter. So let's please welcome back to the show our co-host.
Let's start with you.
Matt Wall.
Hi there.
Natalie, Susi.
Oh, hello.
And Shawn Michael.
Hello.
Welcome back, guys.
Thank you.
What's been going on? How was your Easter? And then most importantly, April Fool's Day was on Friday. I want to know, did anybody get pranked, basically?
Well, I saw your post.
Did you like that?
Can we talk about that real quick?
I got pranked by that.
I didn't know because you didn't, like, nobody commented. So on Friday?
I did.
Friday is it when it was? Did you get pranked by it?
Well, I said I can't wait to be your co-host or your co-star. I think I knew that it was a joke, though.
I didn't. I was like, how do I not know about this show?
So historically, I've always been teased because I try to pull April Fool's Day jokes every year, a prank every year. And so this year, for whatever reason, I woke up, you know, average time, 9 a.m., and I was like, all these April Fool's Day jokes are going around so good. There was like a Trader Joe's one that said that they were all closing. I fell for that one. I don't know if anyone saw that.
Goodness.
I didn't see
that
any of this.
That would be awful.
So they're getting really good, and companies are getting really awesome at, like, fooling you now. Mm. So you really have to be mindful of a lot of things and read the fine print. So I was going through Twitter, and then Progressive Insurance had this thing where it said, looking for an April Fool's Day prank. Click here. We can help you. Mm. So I clicked it, and they created this, like, I want to say it's an app. They created this portal where you can go in, and it creates fake news stories about different things that you want. So you can choose pop culture, entertainment, news, whatever. So you basically just add in your name, and then it generates this whole story around you. So then I was just salivating, of course, at the, you know, the mouth. And so then I was like going through, and there was one that said, you know, pop culture, and then it was a reality show fake news story. So I, plug in my name, and basically the news story was that that there's this new reality TV show for me, and it was called The Wonderful World of David Cruz.
Yeah.
And it's got, like, the photo, and there's, like, a byline. It looks so legit, and I just couldn't help myself, okay? And there were so many other different funny ones that you could have done, and so this one, of course, I post, and it doesn't seem outside of my wheelhouse to be doing
this.
But I think all those close to me, yours, you guys, for example, were kind of, like, thrown off a little bit.
I
post this on Facebook and social media, and so many people are like, congratulations. So excited. And then people were sharing it, and so bad.
Oh, and everyone thinks you're rich.
So if you read the story at the very end, it's the last sentence that says, if you're still reading this is an April Fool's Day joke.
Yeah.
So obviously through the comments, you can tell when people, like, read it or believed it and then came back and was like, ah, you got me. Mm. But I thought that was good my joke. Most successful April Fool's Day
well
prank.
Done.
It was a good
you
one.
You get an A+.
It made me click. I clicked yeah. on it.
If you want to see it, you can head to my Facebook fan page, David Cruz on Facebook, and it's still up, and it's a pretty interesting one. And I think you can still generate your own fake news story if you want.
If you want to get some buzz about yourself going, go yeah. ahead and... Mm. Start generating stories. Mm.
I have to say, the wonderful world of David Cruz sounded pretty fun.
It sounds like a pretty good show. I'd have tuned in for that.
If you read the story, it's actually the story itself too is hilarious because it's not even trying to be serious at all.
Yeah.
It's just trying to be ridiculous and stupid.
Okay, what about this? Is this a bad or a good April Fool's joke? What if you announced on Facebook that you are becoming transgender?
Did you do
it
that?
It would be bad.
Did I do that?
I think that would be
no,
bad.
But no,
I think
the sensitivity, Shawn,
right
within the communities nowadays.
I would like it, though.
You would like it?
Yeah. Okay. I'd be like, I support you.
I am now Chantel.
Chantel. See, for a straight man, I think that you find that entertaining.
Yeah. You see how the humor is different?
I see it.
With those that are more sensitive.
Yeah, so sensitive.
So you guys didn't have any jokes?
I didn't
no
do
jokes
joke
at all?
Play a joke
I don't
on
do the
one
joke
person.
Thing. It doesn't, yeah.
Boo.
Boo, sorry.
No fun.
I
anti-holiday.
No, I didn't.
But I thought yours was very good and creative.
Thank you.
And, you know.
I always get shamed for doing horrible April Fool's Day jokes because they're just like, okay, that's obviously not real, David. Don't do it.
Yeah.
Try again
no
next
year. No
one
fell for that. Wah, I feel like, wah. Though, we haven't seen each other in a really long time.
I
so
know.
Much
we
has happened.
I missed you guys.
Thank you, everyone, for tuning back in because we, you know, it Easter last week, so we weren't here. And then Natalie's been on vacation for a few weeks, and it's just been a little high and low in yeah. here. So now we're all back. We have a great show today. Eli Lieb is here, and he's a singer. He's got this awesome new collaboration that he's done with country singer Steve Grand. We'll be talking with him about the entire song, how it was written, and there's a little bit of story behind it, too. So if you love Eli, he'll be here in a little bit. We'll play the song right before our break, too, and we'll get to talking about all of that. We've got some fun stuff that we'll play after that, too. One quick announcement, too. Not to make the show completely gay today, but a good friend of mine.
Normally it's pretty straight.
Yeah,
huh?
It's super straight.
Super straight.
Every
We're
week.
Super straight over here.
Yeah, not. So a good friend of mine, Rick Clemens, we're going to try to get him on here in the show as well. He wrote this book, just came out recently, and it's about coming out at a later age. He is an older gay man who came out late in life. He has two kids. Like, it's the whole, like, crazy story. He wrote this book. It just came out. It's available at Barnes & Noble, Amazon. Wow. It's called Frankly, My Dear, I'm Gay, A Late Bloomer's Guide to Coming Out by Rick Clemens. I'll hold it up for the cameras if
That's
you're
him,
listening. Like, no, this is not him. Here.
I was that just going to say, that guy
old.
Looks hot.
You're all This is him, Natalie. You into it?
He looks like he could be hot.
He's like, I'm going to turn him back.
Is that him on the back? Is that him on the back?
This is him on the back.
Let me see how old he is.
The older bear on the back side.
Okay, I don't want to see
But
it.
Hold on.
I do. Does he have a cardigan on?
Natalie only wants to see it if he's a salt and pepper gay man or straight man. Well, any kind of man with a cardigan. But what's really awesome, and this is kind of like a weird, awesome, well, it's a cool thing for me, is that on the back side, I gave one of the, and he had requested for me to read the early versions of the book and give a review, and I did, and I didn't realize that. Well, I'm the one of two people that are printed on the backside.
Look at
and
you,
it's pretty cool, right?
Pants.
This is like who does that? I can
That's
pass that around.
Awesome,
it's fun, right?
Yes.
It is awesome.
David Cruz.
I know.
Howard Aww. Stern.
Howard Stern.
All these famous people.
Gayward Stern. but. Yeah, pretty cool stuff. I'm going to try to get him in here soon, so
yeah,
save your questions.
Fine. I have nothing to say right now, then.
Because you're out already.
Can I see?
I'm a late bloomer, too.
You're a late
okay.
bloomer. I guess we could do, you know, should we just
should
go
love
right
it
in?
Or leave
Let's
it?
Let's just
lose it.
Lose it. Okay, yeah. Let's go into that.
We need to talk about this, though, for that we... Let's do it.
Okay. English.
English.
Yeah, yeah, boo-boo.
All right, let's get right into it. As everybody knows, we love to do a cool thing every week called Love or Lose It.
This is important.
I guess you want to do this.
This is important.
Really wants to do this. Bringing to you the latest news, and of course, regarding dating and relationships, is Love or Lose It. It's a fun thing we do every week. This week, for Love It or Lose It, there was a news story that I picked up on about a new thing that's happening within the dating world, and it's called Appless April. Mm-hmm. So according to the story, Appless April is... Well, they're coining this new term because they want you, as it says in the name, to help you refocus on in-person skills and how to react person-to-person, human-to-human in the world of dating. Mm. I know.
And it's very
difficult.
This
is very hard for everyone to understand, to digest. But the whole thing is that they want you to delete all your apps on your phones and not use your apps. And then through this... three-step process, use these three pointers to refocus on how to communicate person to person.
Yes.
Do you follow me still? So it's a 30-day challenge. And so for 30 days, you get off your what's? Your Tinders.
Your Bumbles, your Happenins.
Your Bays.
Your OkCupids.
Your Grinders.
Your Unravels.
No. Scruffs. Your Bros to Bros.
Your Bros. Get off your Bros. Get on your Bros.
Get off all apps.
Yeah, all of them.
All apps for 30 days. It's a 30-day challenge. Go app-free and to practice skills like flirting, talking to people in person.
Imagine that.
So there's 3 points. And Matt, I'll have you read what those 3 points are. So let's start with the first one.
Number one.
Flex
your flirting muscles. Right?
That's it.
Flex them. Flex them.
Give them a good flex. In order to meet men or women offline, you've got to be willing to show them you're interested. One way is through eye contact.
So we talked about this with Natalie before.
Ooh.
Yes.
Natalie's like great. Charm every time.
Natalie is our flirt expert. You're a flexpert.
I am.
Flirt
flexing her muscles.
I can get most men to come over to me with a... quick stare.
With a good long stare down.
Good long stare.
I have noticed that people just are not good with this. So, Shawn, do you when you go out, do you flirt and is it with a stare? Do you have this like system that you have with
Shawn
women?
Shawn has a funny system.
I know.
In a good way.
Can I buy your drink?
It's real funny.
No, he makes people laugh.
I'm very comfortable with prolonged eye contact. So I will like scan the room just for sort of like for eyeballs for fun sometimes.
Scan the room for eyeballs.
Yeah, that's right. And
you
must
be really successful then.
And you know, you can easily tell by doing that who is interested in you and who is not.
Right.
And you can also see the people who are kind of interested but are actually a little shy. And the people who are overly interested, so you
right.
get a lot of information.
Staring
at you. Is that one
just by
in the corner, the wily eyes,
the wily eyes,
the one giving the blowjob gesture. She wants you.
She wants sucking her finger.
Yeah, sucking her finger,
licking her lips.
Okay,
so yeah, eye contact can give you so much
where
information.
Where do you hang out? First of all,
John.
Eye contact is the way to go.
Yeah, it's really great.
It's
the
great,
window
right?
to the soul.
But I found that people are not comfortable with eye contact and like flirting. It's just like they don't, you get them in person in an environment where there's a ton of like available people and there's a breakdown. So
yeah, we can't.
The first step here is to practice the flirting. And Natalie had such an amazing blog that she did recently for Finding Cupid where you talked about flirting. And we talked about it here in the show as well. And it's something that people need to practice. For sure.
Yeah, you have to get comfortable looking in people's eyes for a little bit longer than you normally would, which I was totally uncomfortable with for a while until I realized the results.
The power.
Yeah, the best practice is to just walk around and don't break eye contact until the other person does, which is really uncomfortable if you're not used
really
to it.
Really uncomfortable.
And then quickly leave the club because you're a creep.
Yeah,
right.
But
number
you've
two.
Gotten your practice in.
Yeah,
we're moving on.
Okay.
Take action each week to expand your social circle.
Mm. So make new friends. Go to parties, accept invitations.
Yes.
This is something that a lot of people that aren't comfortable with the in-person thing have challenges with, you know, going to parties by themselves, going to dinners, and being vulnerable to other people. So they're saying that for 30 days, you know, go out, be social, and make new networks, make new connections. Be bold, be brave.
People be ready.
Leave
out there.
The hood that you're in. I went to Santa Monica last night. It was like a whole new world.
Right.
Oh,
that's so
my
funny.
My gosh.
Yeah. But it
whole
is. It's true.
That's why you were late today because you were coming back from Santa Monica.
No, I didn't. I was a good girl. I got home by 12. I just didn't sleep last night because I stubbed my toe and it stuck me, kept me up all night.
All night?
Literally.
You need to work on that excuse.
Yeah, that's all right.
No, I'm serious. It was like a really bad one. It was like throbbing all night, but not in a good way.
Good.
Number three. Go public.
So telling your closest friends what you're doing, that you have this new strategy, hoping that they can, you know, engage along with you and go out with you, create your squad and go out and
ask
make
for
new
support.
Adventures.
And maybe ask them to do it too, so you can support each other, and then you can go out together to go to parties.
We should do a Finding Cupid flirting night, like teach people how to flirt.
Absolutely.
Mm. Wouldn't that be fun?
That would be really fun and uncomfortable. You are breaking up into partners, and you're just going to stare for 5 seconds. Okay. But that's kind of the point. I mean, it's like people don't know how to do it.
People could watch us do it. just watch the masters at work, and then go try it. It's teaching. I'm good at this.
I think that'd be fun. Let's do it.
So do you like this, or should we lose it?
So, yeah, let's go around. Start with Shawn. Like, love it or lose it.
I love this so much. This is my favorite thing so far that's happening in the dating world. It's amazing.
Over all the apps we've talked about.
Yes, this is my
the
favorite.
The app list that you like the best.
This is my favorite because I believe that, you know, we should be connecting in a more personal, more real way. And I don't like that we use dating apps as a crutch.
Yeah.
And I really think that a lot of us are just missing a lot of essential social skills.
Right.
And if we can even have a awareness month on it, I'm so happy.
Awareness month.
I'm awareness month about it. I'm so happy.
Human awareness month.
Yeah.
Okay, so he loves it.
He loves it.
Natalie, love it or lose it?
I'm with Shawn. I love it. I think it's awesome that we are promoting people getting together in real time. So everyone would rather have that story anyway.
Yeah.
You know?
Would you take this 30-day challenge?
Yeah, of course. I will take this 30-day challenge.
Okay. So, Shawn, will you do it too?
Well, yeah, of course.
But you're dating
for
someone.
You,
kind of
course. Anyway.
For you, of course.
Anything for me, right?
Anything for you, David.
Stop flirting with me.
Eye contact.
Stop it.
Eye contact.
So it's uncomfortable.
What about you, Maddie?
Maddie, love
yeah,
or lose
I've
it?
Done it. I deleted them all anyway.
You've done it?
You're already I already did it. I did it while we were talking. Appless. I'm Appless.
Okay.
I threw away my phone. Yeah. Down the toilet.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Well, I'm dating someone, so I deleted them all because I wanted to focus on that.
Saying that out loud. Okay. That's pretty exciting.
He's making a statement.
He took me. It's going great. So I deleted them all.
Oh, nice.
Aww.
But I think I would do it anyway because the guy I'm seeing, we met organically anyway, and it's
so much better.
I don't know. It's great.
It's a nicer story.
Yeah. I agree. Well, I love it as well. I think it's a great challenge for everyone who's out there dating. Definitely work on your skills. And maybe I think as Team Cupid, we should give some pointers here as far as like how to do these
how
things.
How to get
so
through the month.
We'll work on a few pointers and put that up on our website. Of course, you can go to finding-cupid.com for more advice and a bunch of other stuff. So always go there. Always subscribe and check out all the information we give you. If not here, there on the website. So that's Love or Lose It for the day. If you have anything that you've seen in your world that you think might be of interest to us, send it our way. You can always send it to me.
Email it.
David@finding-cupid.com. All right. Fun stuff coming our way today. Eli Lieb is in the house. He will be here momentarily. He and country singer Steve Grand recently collaborated, and they just this past week released a song called Look Away. It's at like a gajillion views already on YouTube.
Great song.
Half a million or something.
Yeah. They're literally like killing it right now.
I couldn't look away.
You couldn't. That's why it's in so many.
Such a good song.
It's captivating.
And they're clothed. You would think they're
are hot though. Let's
not in my mind. They're not.
They're not clothed in your mind. But they're hot for you, Natalie?
Yeah, really.
Do you know
that
they're two very good-looking gay men, right?
I know. This is what Sean keeps telling me, but it's like that Craig Brandon thing again. They're just
Natalie loves gay men.
I do.
She just likes any man who is attractive.
Who has
those
like chiseled facial features?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Natalie, do you need a bib?
Like, shut up.
He's like, Natalie. Okay. So we're going to go grab Eli from the green room before he leaves us.
Oh, hey.
Oh, my God.
Ooh, can't find him.
Where did he go? We're going to take a quick break. We're going to play you their new song here. Check it out. Listen to it. Tell us what you think about it. When we come back after this quick little break, we're going to talk to Eli about what the song and filming the video meant to him. I know there's a story behind it. You're going to get his own words here live in the studio exclusively with us here on Finding Cupid. So don't go anywhere. This is Eli Lieb featuring Steve Grand on Finding Cupid Radio. This is called Look Away. We'll be right back.
I'll never touch your body again. We gave it our all, but this is the end. So we say that we try, watching you fade. I know it's goodbye, but I can't look away from you. I can't look away. I'm trying to face the truth from the mess that we made. So watching you sleep, your scent on my sheet. Such a bittersweet, beautiful mind haunting my dreams. So I know you'll be fine. Say it's alright. Watching your face, 'cause this is goodbye. But I can't look away from you. I can't look away. I'm trying to face the truth from the mess that we made. So we say that we try, but I can't look away from you. I can't look away. I'll be okay, are you okay? Thinking about the way that we left this, but I grow to regret it. Watching you fade, I know it's goodbye.
And welcome back to Finding Cupid Radio. That was the latest from Eli Lieb featuring Steve Grand. Look Away. He is here live in the studio with us. Welcome to the studio, Eli.
Thank you.
So happy to have you.
So happy to be here.
So early, so on point.
Gratuitous cloud, crowd clapping. How are you doing, my friend?
I'm good. How are you?
Thanks for coming in so early.
I'm always up.
Eli's been in our show once before. It was a minute and a half ago. It's been a while. So happy to have you here. Obviously, such a great time to have you here because of the song coming out recently. Mm-hmm. So let's start from the beginning. You know, the crew just heard the song here, too. I don't know if a lot of our listeners have heard it already. Probably so. There's a million people, gajillion people listening and obviously viewing the song on YouTube. I mean, how does it feel to have such a response so instantly?
It's good. I mean, the view thing to me is like, not, I don't understand it anymore because I've been doing it for so long that I don't know what's good and what's bad, especially now that like Taylor Swift puts out a video and 5 minutes later has like 400 billion views. You're like, oh, yeah,
not
my half a million sort of seems a little small, but it's good. I'm actually more proud less of the numbers and just the response of the song as a writer. I like, especially when you put stuff online, you always get mixed reviews. Always. You can't ever put anything up that like unanimously gets like the vote.
Right.
But
right.
This song, like literally I have not seen one comment anywhere of anybody saying they don't like it. And like, you know, when blogs post about you, then there's like comments on the blog.
Right.
And those people half the time don't even know who you are. And even then those comments were good.
Wait, you read those comments? Eli,
you like when
isn't that like a golden rule? You don't read the comments.
Those ones I don't read very much, but like you can't not read comments this day and age because everything's on social media and you have to be on. It's like not an option to not be on it.
Is it like your constructive criticism? Basically, you're looking for like ways to be better.
No.
I don't think these people can tell you how to be better.
All right, fine. You're just reading the comments.
No, you read it because social media is about interaction.
Gotcha.
And if you didn't scroll through your Twitter and look at all the stuff and interact with people, it would sort of defeat the whole purpose of what social media is providing.
Yeah.
So you talk to the fans. You get in there.
And that's me. You know, a lot of times people will have other people handling their stuff. So.
Yeah. So you handle it yourself.
I do.
He handles it well.
It would be weird to give it. It's like giving off yourself to somebody else.
Do you engage with the trolls or with the
like
commenters?
Troll, what do you mean by troll? Like the ones
the haters.
Who are
the haters.
With the haters?
But every once in a while, as a human being, you have to defend yourself. It's like human instinct. You know, you shouldn't, general rule, don't respond to that stuff.
Yeah.
Because it is a losing battle.
Oh, yeah.
There's no way that you will win. But sometimes, like, after a buildup of not responding, you just, like, crack, and you have to just for your own honor
as a
person.
And that's happened to me a few times where in the very beginning of doing Matchmaker, especially in the crazy Bravo world, like, those people love to comment. They love a good smack talk on Bravo. And sometimes it's really hard not to, and, you know, of course I was told not to do it, and then there's people that write comments, and you just kind of have to respond at some point, because you're just like, why? I mean, people would say horrible things about me, and in the context
about
of the show,
you? How's that possible?
I am the nicest thing to happen.
Yeah.
People
what
will
are they saying?
Everything. It's like, you could post one picture, anything, and, like, somebody will say something, and you're like, how did you even
where did that come from?
Where did that come from?
Gosh, you have to have really thick skin. See, this is why I don't think I could do a reality show.
It's fun, though.
I would get so sad.
It's fun.
It would make me sad.
It's intense.
And then you write good songs about it.
Yeah. So, Eli, it's been a minute since we've had something new from you.
Mm-hmm.
And here comes along not only just a song, but a duet with somebody that is also, you know, very, very prominent within, like, the music world. Steve Grand, how did how did this whole song come about? Like, did he approach you? You know, obviously you're in the same kind of, you know, hemisphere of gay celebrity. I'll just say that. But, like, you know, it's like, you know, you're in the same worlds. And did you, like, were you at a cocktail hour thing?
No, like, when our videos came out a few years ago, that it was funny, people, like, kind of put us as rivals, which we never were. But we released a video at the same time that was...
And he's country, and you're pop,
he's like,
you know, more...
Yeah, I mean, I think they labeled him country. I don't really think he is.
Okay.
But so back then, we, like, started following each other, and then I'd say back in October, he just sent me a Twitter message being like, hey, I'm coming to L.A., let's collaborate on something.
Cool.
So I'm the type of... Because you haven't heard stuff from me lately because I write for other people,
mm-hmm.
and my general process is I like to have an idea... formulated before I go into writing with somebody. Not that that's going to be the idea that we use, but just to have something. Mm-hmm. So after he hit me up about that, I came up with a general idea, like a seed for this song, and then he liked it, and then we expanded on it.
So you always knew it was going to be a duet. It was going to be a collaboration.
Well, yeah, yeah. That's what he approached. And then in my mind, I also think what hasn't been done before. So, like, the first thing people would probably want from us is to have some, like, fun love video with he and I making out. And I knew that was the one thing I did not want to do. Like, there was really a point where I was almost like, we should shoot this video where we're not even in the same scenes. Because I didn't want to give what people expect. But also, to my knowledge, I don't think that there is a love duet sung by two guys before.
No, I don't think so.
So, you know, the whole, like, video of, like my first video that came out that became popular, it was me and my love interest was a guy. So it's like, I feel like, but that's totally
been done.
It's like, who cares anymore? It's it's like normal.
Those are commercials for cereal right now.
Yeah. So you have to constantly think of what, especially when you live your life on the internet and your goal is to have things go viral. Like,
sure.
You have to create a good, if it's music, the song just has to be good, but also thinking ahead, you also think of like, what else can I do to this that will make people want to share it?
So did you know, as you started to go through the process, that the song was going to be a breakup? Like, were there other kinds of songs first?
No, I mean, if you think of I knew it, I wanted it to be a breakup song, and I had this idea of, like, breaking up with somebody where it's mutual, that nobody did anything wrong, but you know you have to separate, and you're at that moment where you're, like, at the door, and you're saying goodbye, and you, like, don't want to.
Right.
So you kind of, like, you can't look away from them. The first idea I had was, like, who will be the first to look away?
Gotcha.
And then it turned into what it is.
Were you in a relationship when you wrote the song?
No.
No.
But both Steve and I had been in enough situations to be able to write from a place of, like, reality. And that's what people respond to the best as well, is when you're writing, like, in any form of writing, is when you're doing it from a real, honest place that's relatable to people. And I think that this song kind of tapped into that.
But coming off of what Matt just asked, but you ended up being in a relationship shortly after that.
Yes.
And then the relationship ended. Talk to us about that.
It's weird. I go back and forth of feeling strange talking about it. Like, I don't want to say I'm exploiting my relationship, but I'm an artist. So it's like Adele talks about her relationships. That's what sort of makes those songs, you know? Mm-hmm. So yeah, we did break up the day before I shot the video. Which is why I'm a mess.
The day before the video.
Like, I'm not an actor. So those, like, Claire Danes chin shiver thing was not
all real.
Not
how
acting.
Long had you guys been dating for?
It's a complicated... We'd been friends for a very long time, and we were together, like, not super long, just a few months. Mm. But it was very... we were very close.
Yeah. Mm.
So it was just a different scenario.
Yeah, it's hard when you break up with a person you've been with that was also your friend for a long time.
Yeah, you kind of feel like you're losing a friend and your relationship.
Yeah, that's bad.
Hmm. You told me an interesting story about the breakup, and it was about how you were getting to that point where the L word was coming up. Can I ask this?
Well, you can ask. I don't know what I don't know how much I want to, like, get in super personal details, you know? But ask me and I'll say yes or no.
The L word had never come up until that point. And then you were breaking it off. I'm using your words now, so you're technically not saying it. Okay. You can say stop if you want me to.
Too personal.
You want to pass?
I want to pass on that one.
Okay. So you end the relationship, and then you have to go film this video. Mm-hmm. Walk me through what you were thinking in your head while filming this video. And the emotions that eventually we see on the video here.
I mean, the video shoot was one day, and it was long. We started in the morning, and the first couple takes that we did there, which was the shots that were in the music studio, I definitely was getting emotional. And then there was many hours in between. We were just singing the song over and over and over and over again. And I kind of sort of got in the zone of not feeling emotional, just like going through the motions. And then when it came time to do the scene where I'm just looking at the camera, which was like the last thing we shot.
Yeah.
The director of it was like, all right, everybody get out of the room. I want Eli to like be in a place to really feel it. And I didn't think I was going to because I just sort of like was tired and whatever. And then all of a sudden, like when he's told everybody to leave and I was just there by myself, like thinking about it, it just like came right in.
Yeah. Do you feel over it now? Do you feel like you're kind of healing on the mend?
Yeah, I mean,
I don't want to say over it because it does take a long time to get over any sort of relationship.
I mean, you move on from stuff. It's what everybody does, no matter how long a relationship, how short, how deep, how not. It's like you just kind of, you don't have a choice but to go forward.
Yeah.
I think I think that there's stuff that I am sad about. Mostly like losing a friendship and a disappointment of like having to be single again, you know, which sucks.
We're going to help you with that. Yeah. I've teased a little bit on social media that we have a little surprise for you a little later in the show that we'll talk to you about. But I think it's great.
A husband
behind door number one.
We're going to marry you off.
You know, I can do that too. So it could all happen here. This is a reality show. We're filming it right now. So let's lift the mood a little bit. You know, you've got a successful song here. How does Steve feel about this? The success of the song, by the way. I mean,
he's super happy with it.
Yeah, it's kind of a different page for him. I feel it's a little different than what we're hearing, but it's also done really well. I think anyone can relate to breakup songs. I've told you before, Eli, I live for a breakup album. I think a lot of great artists do the greatest work, and you know, like it's a breakup album. Yeah. Do you have like a favorite breakup album or song that comes to mind?
I don't know. When I go through a breakup, I don't listen to, like, I would not listen to my song. I listen to songs that make me feel good as opposed to, like, wallow in the misery.
Bridge jumpers. Stay away from
Bridge
jumpers.
No,
so
I'll
listen to, like, Roar, you know, like something, like, empowering that you can't feel sad listening to. Because, like, I feel like after you go through a breakup, everything you look at or don't look at or hear or don't hear can, like, trigger something and ruin your day.
Yeah.
Which is why I think social media is really terrible.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to have to see a picture of this person every time you open your phone. And even like songs right now, like I can't listen to a few songs that are on the radio because it's like full on puts me back to like happy times in this past relationship and I can't do it.
So do you think this is why like someone like Taylor Swift is so successful in her world, someone like, you know, Adele, is that these are just experience. I mean, a lot of people criticize them for, you know, writing about those relationships and experiences a lot. But it's, do you think it's like a completely normal, healthy thing to do that because that's what they're going through?
Yeah. And I think that's why it's successful, you know, because it's not like going in a room and be like, all right, let's write a song about a relationship.
Right.
You know, the most successful art in any form comes from that person really expressing what they've been through, because at the end of the day, we're all human and all experience the same thing.
Yeah.
So if you do it, like, I feel like Adele and Taylor Swift do it in a way that's very relatable. You say something that when somebody hears it, they're like, I've been there. And they also have a raw emotion in how they're portraying it. So it's, you know, I live for writing those kind of songs.
Well, Eli, you just need to go through more breakups. Give us a whole album of this
shit.
I've
got enough.
Taylor Swift.
But I do find like the opening line of the song, there's this weird thing that I always think about relationships, and sometimes it's horrible because I'll be in one and I'll think this, like you'll be in it and then fast forward to not being in it and be like, one day you're going to be somebody that like I can't ever see ever again. But right now you're the person that I'm seeing the most. Yeah. So like the line of like, I'll never touch your body again.
That was the line that got me too. When I heard it, I was like, oh God, that's so real.
Yeah. Cause we've been there.
And like, you think about that.
And opening,
for sure.
Like for songs, opening line is everything because you have to like grab people. And so like for me, that's like, it's such a weird concept that you have this person that you text with all day long, you see every day, you make plans with, and then all of a sudden like
not gone. There ghost
yeah.
Well, because we all have, you know, our infatuation with songs, we're gonna play a little game here. And I thought, you know, since we're talking about your song, breakup songs, and our favorite breakup songs, we should play a little game. I'm going to challenge, I'll put you and Maddie, for example, on one team, and then Shawn and Natalie on another one. So I want to see if you guys, if I can do this right. You know me, when I try to do different things.
Are we going to see what the song is behind you?
Oh,
Turn that
Dang
off.
Dang it.
Just block.
Just block okay. it.
All of you.
Just
no,
I won't. Eye contact.
Eye contact for at least 5 seconds.
I can't do it.
All right. So I'm going to play a snippet of a song. And if you guys can figure out what it is, then you win the point. There's no real prize here except for bragging rights. But I'll play a song, and if you know what it is, scream it out loud. Of course, all our listeners at home can play along. God, I forget that there's a screen behind me.
I'm not looking.
I won't look either.
Natalie, don't look. Sorry. I see you
I'm
looking.
I'm not going to know the song.
Wow, Natalie's cheating already.
You're going to carry a lot.
Britney Spears, hit me one more time.
No. Shawn, stop looking. I see you looking.
I only know my
I don't even know where I'm looking. Oh, it's right there. I see it now. I see it. It's like so
here.
Obviously. I'm just going to get Matt's pretty face, and it will be fine. There you go, Matt.
I want to see if I can turn the screen off.
It's okay. We won't look. We won't
I'm not
look.
Looking.
We won't look.
We won't look.
I'm turning away. I'm looking away.
Okay. I've all turned it around. You can turn around
turn
now.
Let's do it.
Cheaters.
Oh, man.
All right. So the goal of this game is to name the song, and whoever names it obviously gets the point. So I'll play the first clip. Ready?
Wins a book.
Since you've been gone.
I think we're going to lose terribly, Natalie.
You guys are going down.
Good job. All right. So we have a point for Eli. All right. Eli and Matt.
And me. We're on a team.
Sorry. All right. Let's see.
Great tape.
Gautier.
What's the name of it? Natalie, tell me the name of it.
Gautier.
Someone that I used to know.
Eli.
That's a good song.
You get like a half point.
We gave him a hint.
No, you gave him a hint.
Like a half point.
Split it.
Such a good song.
Yeah, we have one.
All right, ready? Right, here's the next one. Oh, wait, that was like a triple.
Don't speak.
Yes, you got it.
That was good, because I was gonna say New Kids. That's what it sounded like.
New Kids
on the block.
I don't even
on the block.
Do they have a sad love breakup song?
You don't know.
I'm sure.
Do they have the block anymore?
They've been through it too.
All right, all right. Here's another one. Ready?
I
will survive.
Ah, Eli got it. All right.
Got it.
You, no, Natalie, the game is
know,
name the song. Not
don't sing along with
I
the
don't
song.
Know it. I can't do it that way.
All right. So we have two and I guess two and two right
two,
now.
Two and
right?
one, but
two right. and 1.5.
Yeah,
but no one's keeping track. Okay. Ready. Hold on. Oh wait.
Alanis Morissette.
Yes, Eli got it.
I remember the titles of these songs.
We did that at karaoke last night.
That was a great song.
It's a good one. All right, really so we're at 3-2. Let's see, one more. This is for you guys. If you don't get this,
Natalie,
you
we
could
gotta
lose.
Get this one.
Ready?
Natalie and Brulia at Torn.
Not yes!
No one sings that song.
That's a good song.
That's a great
I'm a musician.
Song.
Congrats.
Everyone, I'm a musician. I love it.
Do you know what the...
That was good.
Wait, can I just say something?
Yes.
You know what the best breakup song is that's happy?
What?
King of Wishful Thinking. With Julia
King
Roberts, you know?
Of
Pretty Woman.
Starring Julia Roberts.
I'll get over you. That song.
We used to play
I don't know why I'm
college.
Singing it that way.
We
but
used to play
oh my
in college
gosh,
and
that's
someone's going through breakup.
By the way, that's a great
it's the friggin' best song ever.
Album, yeah. All right, Eli, you and Maddie, did you even answer anything?
Yeah, I did.
New Kids on the Block was not a correct answer.
Oh.
It was very wrong.
But, you know, I still helped out.
Yes, you did. He was your training wheels. Great.
You like crushed
work.
It. The support.
Thanks, Eli. Good job. Shawn and Natalie. First of all, Shawn, you didn't
even
try
knew,
to answer.
I knew all of them, but like a split second after he said it.
Yeah, whatever.
Like literally, I was like,
as soon
oh,
as you said it,
I think
knew
everybody enjoyed me singing the most, let's be honest.
So Eli, we have, of course, a little bit of a surprise here. We know that the face you are giving
we
me
We know
right
that you're
now.
Single, and we know that you're
ready to mingle.
Lonely.
You're ready to mingle.
I ain't lonely.
He said that.
What?
Oh, no, I'm just kidding. So, of course, you know, it's our expertise here, and we want to help. So, for all the people listening out there, we've taken it upon ourselves.
Oh, God. This is David.
Here. Oh what? This is a team effort.
Yes,
so
we're here for you.
We got your back here, Eli. You're a friend of the show, friend of mine. And, you know, I want to help. And you have a whole team now behind you. So what we're offering, what we're proposing, should you choose to accept and you can't decline because we've already done certain things.
I legit don't know what's going on.
I know
right
you
now,
don't,
so.
Which is the best part. So we're going to help you. For an entire month, you won't be you could be appless April here if you wanted to. Okay.
Good.
So perfect. Step one. So we're gonna be your own like vetting relationship team giving you advice for the next month. Okay. And then we're also gonna be taking applications to date Eli. So if you head to finding-cupid.com right now, there is a little page called Project Cupid. And this month's
it's
project
bottom,
is Eli.
Project Eli.
Project Eli. So for the entire month.
I'm like the in Clueless. What's her name?
Oh my God. You're Brittany Murphy.
Anyway.
Then she died.
Then she died.
Not in the movie.
Not in the movie.
Not in the movie. So if you go to our website, click on Project Cupid, what we're going to do for the next month is we're going to take applications for you.
Whoa.
This is a good catch, peeps.
Yeah, absolutely. You have four of the most trained professionals and experts within Los Angeles helping you. If you go to Project Cupid and obviously read about Project Eli, he is our client for the next month. We will be taking applications. You send us information about you and why you think you would be a great match for Eli. We will personally vet each of these applicants, and then we'll present them to you and see if anything happens.
No
the next
penis
month.
Pictures, please.
Nope.
No.
Nope.
No.
Natalie. I'm actually like...
or maybe one.
I'm
for
open.
Natalie.
You
for
can.
Natalie.
I'm actually very turned off, even like when you... Just like if somebody in their profiles like have shirtless pictures and stuff.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. We've got a classy guy here.
I don't
here.
Like that.
Yeah,
people.
Class it up, people.
Hey, all right, you hear classy. That, everyone.
Eli will tell us everything that he wants, and then his obvious expectations about what a date would be like. Eli, we're going to set you up, and then at the end of the month, can you come back and report back to us?
Sure.
All right.
Wow. Good thing you said yes.
Yeah, I know. Oh thank God.
That's going
to
be great.
All right. So head to finding-cupid.com. You'll see Project Cupid. Send us your information. Follow all the instructions there. You will also see Eli's video if you haven't seen it already. We'll put it up on our website. And of course, all the other information about Finding Cupid's on there. So if you think you're a good match for Eli, let us know. And we'll
get
take,
in line.
We'll get your application.
Right behind me.
We'll review
me.
You. And if we like you, we'll call you. Don't call us.
We will call you.
Eli, thank you so much for being here on our show today.
Thank you.
Congrats on all your success. Congrats on the video and the song and all this awesome stuff that's happening. And we'll see you in a little bit, it sounds like.
Yeah,
sure.
If you want more information about the show, head to finding-cupid.com. And of course, download our podcast on iTunes. It's free. And of course, follow us on social media. And of course, follow Eli. And maybe he'll have updates on his Snapchat and Twitter.
Ooh, yeah,
and all
he's
that
on
fun
Snapchat,
stuff.
You guys.
Yeah, Eli Lieb.
Everything. Everybody's on everything
he's
now.
Never bored.
Until then, guys, thanks again for joining us back on the show. Great to see you all again on a Sunday, and we'll see you next week. Have an awesome day.
Bye.
Bye.
Shows that make you laugh, shows that make you think, music that moves you. No! It could only be one place. Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at ubnradio.com.